Good morning everyone, my name is Isha. I'm working as assistant professor in Zermatt Engineering College. Okay, today I'm going to discuss about the switch gear in electrical installations. Today I'm going to discuss about the switch gear, okay, the component, and in that switch gear we are going to discuss the component of low tension switch gear. Okay, the components of low tension switch gear. Okay, what is a switch gear? Switch gear is basically divided into depending upon the voltages. It is nothing but high or low voltage level, medium voltage level, and high voltage level. Low voltage level will be up to 1 kilovolt, and high voltage level up to 3 kilovolt to 33 kilovolt, and medium voltage level up to below 33 kilovolt. Okay, depending upon the voltage levels, the switch gear will be classified. Okay, and here what are the equipments whose included in the switch gear means potential transformers, switchers, and relays, and circuit breakers. These are the devices included in the switch gear. Okay, the switch gear is a what is the switch gear? First, we'll see what is a switch gear. Switch gear is an apparatus. Okay, it is an apparatus that it will be protect, that it will be switching, and that it will be protecting the devices. Switching, protecting the devices, and controlling the devices in the circuit elements. It is nothing but the switch gear. Okay, it is nothing but the switch gear. The devices will be included in the switch gear is potential transformer, devices, circuit breaker, relays. These are the devices was included in the switch gear. And we'll see depending upon the voltages. I said depending upon the voltages, then switch gear was classified low voltage level, depending upon the voltage level, switch gear. We'll see switch gear depending upon the voltage. Okay, depending upon the voltage, low voltage. Okay, low voltage. Low voltage switch gear. Okay, low voltage switch gear up to 1 kilovolt. Okay, up to 1 kilovolt is nothing but medium voltage switch gear. Medium voltage switch gear up to 3 kilovolt to 33 kilovolt. Okay, 3 kilovolt to 33 kilovolt. And next, high voltage switch gear. Okay, depending upon the voltage level, the switch gear is classified. Okay, the switch gear is classified into three types. High voltage switch gear above 33 kV. But in our components of low voltage, okay, low tension switch gear. Here, low voltage switch gear will be used in the domestic, okay, low domestic appliances, and medium voltage switch gear will be used in the some industries, and high voltage switch gear was used in the substations, okay, substations. So today we are going to discuss about the low voltage switch gear up to 1 kV, okay, up to 1 kV. This switch gear was again divided into, okay, four types. It is nothing but first one is a switch fuse unit. Switch fuse unit. Okay, switch fuse unit. And second one is a MCB. It is nothing but miniature circuit breaker. Miniature circuit breaker. Miniature circuit breaker. Okay, and third one is the MCCB. It is nothing but modulate case circuit breaker. Modulate case circuit breaker. Okay, modulate case circuit breaker. And fourth one is a earth leakage circuit breaker. Okay, earth leakage circuit breaker. Okay, earth leakage switches. So first we'll see what is a fuse. Okay, in the olden days we used to use as a fuse. Okay, when the high voltage, okay, any fluctuations was coming from the lines to our homes, the fuse will be behave just like a mediator. Okay, from the lines supply and to our home, the fuse will be behave just like a mediator. So with the high voltage, when the fluctuation was coming from the lines and under voltage level, okay, the fuse will be behave just like a guard to our homes. Okay, when high voltage was occurred near to the fuse, it will be melted. Okay, it will be melted, and after that we see, after that the lights will be off, the supply will be off to our home. So we go and see what happened. That fuse will be melt, and again after seeing that, the fuse will be replaced by the human supply. Okay. By the human, we will use to remove the fuse, and again we will replace the fuse again. Okay, as usual it will be turn on. As usual it will be on the light. Okay, on the light. This is a fuse. This is a switch fuse unit. The first one is a switch fuse unit, and the next one is a miniature circuit breaker. Okay, the present now in our homes we are using the miniature circuit breaker, not the fuse. Okay, what is the difference between the fuse and the miniature circuit breaker? Means in the fuse, when the high voltage was occurred, the fuse will be melted. But here, the man should remove the fuse, and again we should be replaced. In this miniature circuit breaker, we won't use any component. Okay, we won't remove any component. Okay, automatically it will be trip. Okay, when the high voltage or any fluctuations was occurred from the lines, the miniature circuit breaker will behave just like a mediator to our homes. Okay, they protect. Okay, miniature circuit breaker will protect to our homes. Okay, mediator behaves just like a mediator to our homes. So what here do the miniature circuit breaker means? When the high voltages was occurred, okay, under voltage was occurred, any fluctuations was occurred, it will be trip automatically. Okay, it will be trip automatically, and after some time, by the manpower, we will be on the miniature circuit breaker. We won't remove, as if we use the fuse, we have to go and remove the component and we have to replace another one, the new one. But here in the miniature circuit breaker, we are not removing any component. We are just when the high voltages and fluctuations was occurred, the miniature circuit breaker, it will be tripped, and after some time we go and on it. Here the difference between the fuse and the miniature circuit breaker. Now the present days we are using the miniature circuit breaker. So this is a diagram of the miniature circuit breaker. So now we are going to see the working principle of miniature circuit breaker. How the high voltage was coming, because of the how the high when the high voltage was occurring, under voltages was occurring, and fluctuations was occurring, how the MCB, it is nothing but miniature circuit breaker was applied. It is nothing but working principle. Okay, this is a circuit breaker. This is the main diagram of the MCB. It is nothing but now we are going to see the working principle of MCB. It is nothing but circuit breaker. Okay, it is nothing but metallic bar. This is a metallic bar, and this is a trip bar. Okay, this is a trip bar, and this is a bimetallic bar. Okay, and this is a bimetallic bar. So here this is nothing but line. Okay, this is nothing but line currents. Okay, this is nothing but line currents, and this is nothing but load. Okay, load here from the load it is nothing but our ohms. Okay, load it is nothing but our ohms. Here the current was entering, the line current was entering the circuit breaker, and here from the circuit breaker it will be enter into the metallic bar, and again here metallic bar will be connected to the this one bimetallic bar, and bimetallic bar was connected to the trip bar. Okay, and here the one more connection from the circuit breaker, here it is nothing but latch. Okay, here it is nothing but latch. Okay, here it is nothing but latch. When the current was coming from the lines, okay, here it was not occurring any high voltage. voltages, here it is not occurring any high voltages and lower currents and any fluctuations was not occurred. So here the circuit breaker is not functioning. When for an example, from the line, the fluctuations was occurring 100 voltages and higher currents were flowing from the lines. Here the circuit breaker, the circuit breaker will capture that one and sends the signals to the metallic bar and metallic bar to again by metallic bar. When the high voltages, under voltages and fluctuations was occurred, it will be captured the circuit breaker and give the signals to this bimetallic bar. Bimetallic bar. Here the bimetallic bar will be melted. Bimetallic bar will be melted. This melted bimetallic bar will be attached to the latch. It will be touched to the latch. It is nothing but this bimetallic bar will be melted. It will be bent like this. After bending this bimetallic bar, the clip bar, the clip bar will touch this latch. The clip bar will touch this latch. Because of this latch, the clip bar was touched this latch. Here what will be open? This contact will be open. This contact will be open. So now the circuit breaker, it is nothing but miniature circuit breaker, will be tripped. Automatically will be tripped. So this is a working principle of the MCB. This is a working principle of the MCB. We did not see how the MCB was working when high currents or fluctuations was coming from the line. Here the circuit breaker will sense the high voltages and under voltages, and that sensed one will give to the metallic bar, and this metallic bar will give to supply to the bimetallic bar. Here bimetallic bar will be melted and it will be slide. And this strip bar was attached to the bimetallic bar. It will be bent to the latch. It will be bent to the latch. Here the latch will be open. What happened? Here the miniature circuit breaker, it is nothing but miniature circuit breaker, will trip automatically. This is our principle of the miniature circuit breaker. Now we'll see about the earth leakage circuit breaker. And here, one more thing, miniature circuit breaker will be used under the low voltage, low currents. Here, MCCB, the modular case circuit breaker, will use in the high currents, high current. That current is nothing but 2500, 2500. Trip coil. It is nothing but relay. When the supply was given to this coil, here what was happened, the magnetic flux was there. Okay,